Praise the Lord. Welcome to the sessions of 7 prophetic blessings of the day from Kadosh Marian Ministries. According to Ephesians chapter 1 verses 21, far above all rule and authority, power and dominion, and every name that is invoked, not only in the present age, but also in the one to come. This is the word of the Lord. Today's theme for the Emmanuel experience is to taking authority in the name of Jesus. Heavenly Father delegated the entire authority to Jesus, and Jesus Christ delegated His authority to His beloved people. Jesus promised that I have given you the authority to trample over snakes and scorpions and overcome all the enemies without any fear and harm. He was giving to believers the right to exercise power in His name over the power of Satan, God's enemy and ours. One definition of authority is the power to rule, the power of one whose will and commands must be obeyed by others. In the beginning, God gave Adam the authority to rule or to exercise power in the Garden of Eden. According to the word of the Lord, He subdued over everything. Only one tree was declared off limits, but in yielding to Satan's temptation to eat the fruit of that tree, humankind went beyond the boundary of their God-given authority. So sin would have power to rule over the human race. Why was the devil so determined to seduce men and women to sin? Satan wanted the authority God had given to man. Although he was on the planet, the devil did not have authority and jurisdiction over the planet. Satan knew that man could use or misuse the authority given to him. When man disobeyed God, Satan was able to gain the authority illegally. Just as God transferred some authority to His people, so the people of God passed it on to Satan. But Satan can only use it through man. He can only influence the world to the degree that the man chooses to sin and live in disobedience to God. This is what we might call the balance of power. My dear brothers and sisters, we were listening the definition of authority, origin of sin, and how authority transferred. Now we enter into the most important topic, which is a relationship with Jesus for the authority. Through His sacrificial death, burial, and resurrection, Christ defeated Satan's power and received from God's authority over all angels and powers. Now humankind, through Christ, can regain the authority that Adam surrendered. Now the balance of power on the earth rests with the man in the name of Jesus Christ. The authority is complete in man as long as man is in relationship with God through Jesus Christ. With our authority comes the responsibility to use it for God's purposes. If we don't rebuke the devil, he will not be rebuked. If we don't drive him back, he will not leave. It is up to us. Satan knows our authority, but hopes we will stay ignorant. We must be as convinced of our authority as the devil is. Relationship is the key. Without a close relationship with Christ, we have no basis for taking authority over Satan, and he knows it. But God has placed Christ at His own right hand in heaven, in a position of authority over all other powers. And because we are a part of His body, the church, we can use His name with authority. The book of Acts records the story of a group of men who tried to their sorrow to cast out demons in the name of Jesus when they had no relationship with Him. Some Jews who went around driving out evil spirits tried to invoke the name of the Lord Jesus over those who were demon-possessed. They would say, "In the name of Jesus whom Paul preaches, I command you to come out." One day the evil spirit answered them, "Jesus I know, and I know about Paul, but who are you?" Then the man who had the evil spirit jumped on them and overpowered them all. He gave them such a beating that they ran out of the house naked and bleeding. He was given authority, glory, and sovereign power. All people, nations, and men of every language worshipped Him. His dominion is an everlasting dominion that will not pass away, and His kingdom is one that will never be destroyed. Once the crowds were amazed at his teaching, because he taught as one who had authority and not the teachers of the law, but with the divine authority. Once Jesus, he himself said that, so that you may know that the Son of Man has authority on earth to forgive sin. Then he said to the paralytic, "Get up, take your mat and go home." And the man got up and went home. When the crowd saw this, they were filled with awe, and they all praised God who had given authority to such a man, Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ laid down his life for his sheep. No one takes it from Jesus, but he himself lay it down for his own accord, because Heavenly Father has given him the authority to lay it down and to take it up again. This authority received by Jesus Christ from the Heavenly Father. Therefore, God exalted him to the highest place and gave him the name that is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. My dear brothers and sisters, Christ is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn over all creation. For by him all things were created, things in heaven and on earth, visible and invisible, whether thrones or powers or rulers or authorities. All things were created by him and for him. He is before all things, and in him all things hold together. And he is the head of the body, the church. He is the beginning and the firstborn from among the dead, so that in everything he might have the supremacy. My dear brothers and sisters, we listen first the definition of authority, then we listen the origin of sin, then we understood how the authority has been transferred, then we found the relationship, and finally we understood that scripture is proving his authority. Hallelujah! With the divine authority, divine supremacy, Jesus Christ wanted to bless you. So we are blessing you from the house of the Lord. May you be able to understand the power and authority of Jesus. May you be able to bind and cast out enemy by the name of Jesus. May you be able to apply the name of Jesus appropriately. May you overcome all temptations and worldly passions by the name of Jesus. May you be able to fight the good fight in faith. May you be a blessing when you come in and go out of your home. May you, your job, and your family be a blessing. We seal all these blessings in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. I'm Thomas George from Kadosh Marian Ministries. Thank you.